Championship night inside Carver Arena, Peoria, Illinois. Start of the year 2000, Illinois Boys Class A Basketball Tournament. And welcome to the third place game. The Hawks of Riverton meet the Storm of Bureau Valley. Good evening once again, everybody. Dave Ennett alongside David Kaplan. Welcome once again to America's original March Madness. And we begin our coverage tonight with a third place game. Both of these teams had hoped to be playing for a championship a little bit later on this evening. Instead, they will battle for third place. Riverton got here by winning the Warrensburg Sectional, the Decatur Super Sectional, then beat defending champ Rock Falls last night before losing to Pleasant Plains in triple overtime today, 78-68. Bureau Valley came out of the Mendota Sectional, the DeKalb Super Sectional, beat Prairie Central yesterday and then lost to second rank Teutopolis earlier today, 60-42. It's always tough to play the third place game, but Kaplan, has to be especially tough for Riverton because they've only had about 3 hours to get ready for this game.
Well, emotionally, you're drained. Both clubs are because they're not playing for the ultimate prize tonight. But you're right, for Riverton, triple overtime. I think they missed 5 free throws in 1 overtime session. You're devastated. It's hard to get back up, but these are kids. They're resilient. Once the ball goes up, they'll be ready to play.
Let's take a look at a couple of the key performers in action earlier today. Clint Pupple of Riverton and Justin Yepsen of the opponent's Bureau Valley.
Well, Clint Pupple can fill it up from way downtown. He can score inside. He goes to the glass. He defends. He's perhaps the best Class A player this year in the state of Illinois. Justin Yepsen, more of a role player. Pupple the star. Yepsen does it all, though. He rebounds. He passes. He scores. Last night, yeoman work on the boards. He's got to be big on the glass tonight.
All right, third place at stake in this game. Later on tonight, we will bring you the championship game as Teutopolis will take on Pleasant Plains. Back with the introductions coming up.
These days, seems like everybody's always reachable, instantly accessible. Until there's a busy signal, a hold message, and the realization that your insurance company isn't there for you. Enter Country Companies, where you'll always talk to real people with real answers real quick. After all, what good is a phone if there's no one there to listen? Country Companies Insurance.
Hello, I'm Jim Corno, Senior Vice President and General Manager of Fox Sports Net Chicago. This year, our sports awards dinner raised over $210,000 benefiting the March of Dimes. This money will go to support the battle against birth defects. On behalf of all of us here at Fox Sports Net, I'd like to thank everyone who supported the dinner and encourage you to support the March of Dimes all year long.
Feast your eyes on gorditas from Taco Bell.
Ooh!
Warm, pillowy flatbread loaded with seasoned beef and all your favorite stuff. Choose from Baja, Santa Fe, or Supreme.
Ay, ay, ay.
And right now, they're just 49 cents each when you buy any drink. So you can afford to share some with a friend.
Hello, friend.
Gorditas, now just 49 cents with any drink. Grande taste, local value, only at Taco Bell.
The best taste for me is Pepsi when I'm cruising down the streets of the NYC. Me and my boy just shooting the breeze.
When the streets of LA, we sipping a Pepsi. Cause the effervescent joy, they only call it for me.
The joy of flavor.
The joy of fun.
The joy of bubble.
Hold on your tongue.
The joy of cola.
Y'all need a lift? Ooh,
ooh. Joy cola.
Yeah.
Fox Sportsnet's coverage of the IHSA Basketball Championships is brought to you in part by Pepsi, the joy of cola. Country Companies, when it matters most, the country's behind you. Hyundai, where driving is believing. Taco Bell, grande taste, local value. And by the Chicago Tribune. Check out the Preps Plus pages every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday in the Chicago Tribune Sports section. And watch Chicago Tribune's Preps Plus on Fox Sportsnet. Riverton and Bureau Valley here tonight in our third place game in this Class A championship. Let's bring in the third member of our crew. And here's Steve Schlanger. Hey, Steve.
Hey, Dave, how you doing?
Good.
Well, as you say, fatigue will certainly be a factor for each team tonight, even more of an issue for Riverton with only that three-hour turnaround between games. However, head coach Jeff Koger says not to worry. Pride is always at stake when his team takes the floor. They have several seniors playing their final game tonight, and they also have a chance to close it out with 30 wins. He also says it's always nice to win your last game instead of dropping two straight, guys.
All right, Steve Schlanger, thank you. Let's go to Paul Herzog, the public address announcer, for the introduction.
Good evening, basketball fans. On behalf of the Illinois High School Association and the city of Peoria, welcome to America's original March Madness. Tonight's Class A third place game in Carver Arena features the Riverton Hawks, a record of 29-4, and the Manlius Bureau Valley Storm, a record of 25-5. Let's meet the starting lineups. At a forward for Riverton, the 6'3 senior, number 24, Justin Barton. And a forward for Bureau Valley is 6'5 junior, number 4, Ruben Slott. The other forward for the Hawks, the 6'1 senior, number 50, Jason Tolley. The other forward for the Storm, a 6'2 senior, 22, Justin Yepsen. At center for Riverton, a 6'6 senior, 22, Clint Couple. One of three guards of Bureau Valley, a 6'1 junior, number 20, John Elliott. And a guard for the Hawks, a 5'9 senior, number 30, Trevor Bowles. Another guard for the Storm, a 5'8 senior, 24, Adam Endres. Another guard for Riverton, a 6'1 senior, number 20, Brian Hartlaub. And the third guard for Bureau Valley, a 6'2 sophomore, number 32, Phil Endres.
There they are, the Storm of Bureau Valley, as we take a look at the coaches for tonight's game. That's Jeff Koger in his 11th year as the head coach of Riverton, 234 victories against just 83 losses. He has had four consecutive 20 victory seasons. You saw him exchanging handshakes with Brad Bickett, 87-52 in 5 years. At Bureau Valley, he is the only coach in the school's five-year history. He has not had a losing season. The Storm had won five straight regional titles before winning a super sectional in its first try this year. There are our officials, Larry Bruck of Ottawa, Eugene Duffy, also of Ottawa, and Mark Mayhood of Effingham will officiate this third place game here tonight. And let's look at our Hyundai Keys to Victory cap.
Well, emotional rescue. Who's going to have the emotions to carry you through probably a bit of a tired leg syndrome when you play two ball games at this level in probably 6 hours? The couple shuffle? Can Clint Couple really get it rocking and rolling early?
Did you come up with that?
Absolutely. No, Jim Corno Jr. did. And Bureau Valley, aggressive zone. They've got to extend it down to the baseline. It's been trouble for them here two times in this tournament where they've given up easy shots. Get a look at Couple against Ruben Slock. Should be a good matchup. I think Couple's primed and ready to go out in style one more time to rock and roll in front of the crowd here.
24 points and 19 rebounds for Couple earlier today, and he knocks it to the arms of his teammate Brian Hartlaub. These guys all played very heavy minutes earlier today. Not only did he have the 24 and 19, Couple also blocked five shots, had a couple of steals, and there's a steal the other way, Ruben Slott. And down the court comes Adam Endres, who seemed to be just about everywhere in the semifinal, but on the floor an awful lot.
Exactly.
A lot of floor burn. Runner out of bounds. In that first game today, as you look at Couple, Bureau Valley got off to kind of a slow start.
Tertopoulos grabbed a 17-12 lead after one quarter. There from the left side, the shot no good by John Elliott. And we get the first foul of the ball game called on Slock. Slock did not have a big game, did not put up the gaudy numbers we've seen him come up with, Cap, earlier today. 8 points on 3 of 7 shooting against Tertopoulos.
No, he didn't. He was focused in trying to help out a lot defensively at the top of that zone, but offensively he struggled a bit.
Spinning to the basket was Jason Tolley. Draws the foul. I think Elliott called for the foul. No, check that. It was not. It was called on Phil Endress. Tolley at the line. And free throws a big problem earlier today, as we'll discuss, for Riverton, and that continues here. And look at the intense pregame action out on the court with Attitude, the IHSA mascot, and our own David Kaplan with a strong move to the hole.
Strong.
And it's 1-0 in favor of Riverton.
These guys are very funny.
Adam Andrus lays it in, and Bureau Valley takes the lead 2-1.
That guy couldn't make a junior varsity team. His life depended on it. No way. Couldn't make the frosh stop.
I'm sure, Cap, that you'll be recording that when this game is replayed and save that for posterity. Here's the steal, and the other way. Or Riverton, Trevor Bowes. The heart lob. Now a couple up top. Back it goes to Tolley.
Boy, yes. Tried to blow.
Just think the legs aren't there?
The legs are gone.
Now, you didn't play triple overtime today either. Good start here for Bureau Valley, up 4-3, and they're going inside to get their points. Oh, and a collision at the other end. There's Hartlob.
And of course, who's on the floor again getting run over? That poor kid's gonna need a lot of Advil tonight. Here comes Riverton in transition. There's the contact. He never ceases to amaze me. Tell you what, Adam Endress steps up and always is around the ball and is willing to lay his body out there for the good of the team.
4-3 Bureau Valley early in this third place game. Reverse layup by Justin Yepsen. We talked about him in the opening. He had 10 points earlier today. Now from the right side, the three-point effort no good by Hartlob. Bureau Valley comes out of there with it.
Riverton just looks a step slow right now, which is understandable considering they played a triple overtime game till about 4 o'clock.
Blocking foul called. The game ended a little bit before 3:30. So they had just about, probably about, what, 2.5 hours before they had to come back to the arena.
Get something to eat. Switch your gear around to the dark uniforms and come back and play. One play.
Adam Endress, 53% free throw shooter, makes them both. 8-3 Bureau Valley. Riverton bringing it up, and a blocking foul called, and getting up from the floor is Adam Endress.
It's getting physical already. Adam Endress twice has been involved in plays where he's trying to take a charge. Does he get there? He's a little late, but the arm did come out.
Trevor Bowes has 40 pounds on it. That's his brother, Phil Endress, grabbing the rebound, finding his brother. Yepsen. Endress. Back to Yepsen. The high-low into Slot, lost it on the floor. Still loose, out of bounds. It will be Bureau Valley ball. And Lord Burns are starting to pile up here, and we've only played about 3 minutes in this game. It's 8-3, Bureau Valley, 4:46 for the first.
These days, seems like everybody's always reachable, instantly accessible. Until there's a busy signal, a hold message, and the realization that your insurance company isn't there for you. Enter Country Companies, where you'll always talk to real people with real answers real quick. After all, what good is a phone if there's no one there to listen? Country Companies Insurance.
Want to share my joy?
Joy Cola! Terry Cola!
Yo, Mary, wait up!
The broadcast rights for this event have been granted to Fox Sports Net and Intersport Television by the Illinois High School Association. Any reproduction or rebroadcast without the express written consent of Fox Sports Net, Intersport, and the IHSA is strictly prohibited. 8-3, Bureau Valley. Leading Riverton with 4:46 to go in the first quarter of this third-place game. Clint Couple, scoreless thus far, early shooting, 33% shooting by Riverton in the early going, 60% by Bureau Valley. Off the inbounds play, Slock missed it. Bowes the other way, now Couple. Ryan Hartlove on the baseline is fouled. Right, check that, out of bounds.
Yeah, I think when it got into some contact on the baseline, the ball went off his leg and went out of bounds.
And Endress brings it up for Bureau Valley. Endress, jumper from the right, missed it, got his own rebound.
Boy, he's a hustler, isn't he?
There is a foul, and it's called on Hartlaw. That's the second on Brian Hartlaw, the tri-captain of this Riverton squad. Phil Endress returning, Slock over on the bench, getting a breather. You know, we're focusing on how fatigued Riverton must be, but let's keep in mind that Bureau Valley was playing for their chance of the championship not long before,
just a couple hours before.
Muscling for the rebound. There's the block by Couple. Running the floor, Bowes. Couple bobbled out of bounds. Bureau Valley ball. And I wonder, Cap, you know, we talk a lot about, well, it wasn't just the ball that went out of bounds. Zulov ended up in the seats.
And here it is, coming right into your living room. Here comes Zulov. He's going to try and save it. Now he goes right over the scorer's table, or the press table.
You have to have a credential, actually, to sit there.
Right, he was asked to leave.
And the pass at the other end, off the hands.
But he did
off Barron's.
Put on some bad polyester and went for a free meal.
And felt right at home.
And thought he was a great athlete at the time. Like a media guy, right?
Like somebody who would go on off one with a mascot. Bringing it up is Trevor Bowes.
Knew you were going there.
And the pass, Endress with a good hustle play, but it's stolen back by Bowes. Couple, a measure of three from straight on. Got it. Clint Couple. At 6'6", he can step out and shoot that three-pointer.
He's going to be a real good addition to the Evansville Purple Aces program.
He was an early signee there, and he's talked about how that took some pressure off him to sign early. He's been able to concentrate on helping this team to 29 victories. On the weak side, the put back no good. There's Zulov. Now three by Bowes from up top, got it.
And just like that, Riverton takes the lead. Timeout, Bureau Valley.
Brad Pickett's very unhappy. It's a 20-second timeout. He does not like the effort being expended by his guys on the glass right now.
Take a look at the three-point shooting shown here by Riverton.
Well, Bose has time to make a sandwich, load it up, knocks it down. Zuloff, very perceptive. He has it, he wants to go up, he says, wait a minute, my buddy's wide open. Gets the feet set, boom, drills it.
Riverton, 29-4 on the season. Hawks have won 8 of their last 9, 15 out of 17. Bose, 5'9", 180. And Bureau Valley brings it up. 2.5 to go in the first quarter of this third place game. Fadeaway shot would not go. Matt Tumbleson of Bureau Valley has come in. Tumbleson, a senior, and I would imagine we'll see more of the reserves for both these teams tonight.
Absolutely, because the game, yeah, you want to finish third instead of fourth, but this is the last chance for the seniors to play.
You want to give them a taste of action. Behind the back dribble, and Endress off the mark.
Jepsen over the top. Nope, they're going to give it to Tumbleson.
Matt Tumbleson called for the foul. Nifty move there by Endress.
There's Tumbleson and Jepsen going over the top, and you can see the body from 34. Let's get a look at John Elliott, a 6'1 junior.
Elliott, 2 points in the ball game. Riverton with the basketball, leading by 3. Barton DeBose. The starters for Riverton, Barton and Couple, both played 44 minutes in that semifinal game. Tolley played 40, Hartloff 43, Zuloff 39. And keep in mind, a regulation high school basketball game is 32 minutes. And now they're playing a second game today.
Couple just yells, it's a bounce pass. Tough to bounce it into the paint, though. A lot of hands and a lot of feet in there.
Turnovers in the early going with all those hands and feet. Riverton, 6 turnovers already. Deep three-pointer, got it, drilled by Phil Endress.
Well, he squared up and had no doubt in his mind he was going up from the get-go.
First three ball for Bureau Valley. We're tied at 11. Valley, 47% of its three-pointers in their quarterfinal win over Prairie Central yesterday. Phil Endress, 3 of 7. Three-pointer at the other end, no good. And rebound, Jepsen. 3-on-2. Jepsen. Block. Shot rejected by Couple. And Riverton, Zuloff picks it up. So 2 blocks for Couple, who had 5, or a 7-block day so far.
He's done very well. They had 19 boards in the semi.
10 of 15 shooting. The problem for Riverton, free throws. 45% from the line in that semifinal, 13 of 29. They had their chances, particularly late in regulation and in the overtime. Will do it for the first quarter of this third place game. It's dead even through 8 minutes. Brad Pickett and Bureau Valley tied with Riverton 11 apiece. We'll be back with more March Madness.
If you really want to know Chicago from people who know Chicago, click here. Metro Mix, Chicago's complete online entertainment guide.
is a lot like wrestling. We both love action. We both love the big hits. We both love performing for the millions and millions of our fans. There is, however, just one difference. Hockey's scripted, right?
Blackhawks, Lightning, today at 4:30 on Fox Sports Net.
Welcome back to Carver Arena in downtown Peoria. Dave Bennett, David Kaplan, along with Steve Schlanger. We begin the second quarter of the third place game, and coming up later on, it's the championship in Class A, Pleasant Plains against the Wooden Shoes of Tutopolis. There's Trevor Bowes, Riverton. Bowes thus far with 5 points in the game. Hit both his shots from the floor, including a three-pointer. And we're tied at 11. 44% shooting by Riverton, 29% by Peoria Valley in that first period. Blocked in the corner. Got it. Long deuce by Ruben Slott.
All right, there's a 3-2 defense out of Riverton. A zone, and Slott gets an opening right where the vulnerability is on that defense. In the corner on the baseline.
And Bowes draws iron and draws Riverton back in front, 14-13.
Now they're in a 2-3 zone.
Pass deflected. Saved by Elliott. Slock from almost the same spot. Couple the rebound. Couple whips it back out. And the turnaround, got it.
He is so tough. He had that play all set in his mind, went right down to the post, got the ball, had a little bit of spacing, and got the shot off.
Phil Andrus, this is becoming a three-point contest. Though we had our country company's three-point showdown earlier today.
There was some great shooting in that. Couple
lay-in.
Got up-tempo basketball at its best right now. You got a stallion-like Couple. You'll see a lot of points on the board.
Jepsen back out. Another three-point attempt. Good again. John Elliott gets into the act. 19-8. Well, you have to think both these teams are loose right now, Cap.
And neither one wants to spend the effort to get down and really guard you. They're tired.
Three-point shooting in the ball game. 60% Riverton, 100% Bureau Valley. Now the drive cut off on the baseline, John DeRosa. Bowes has hit both his three-point attempts. Hart lob. Timeout Riverton. 20-second timeout taken by the Riverton Hawks.
I love the 20-second timeout that was put into basketball. It's always been at the NBA level, but the lower levels, just a couple years ago, it's a great, great thing to have. Now take a look. Against this defense, you see there's a 3-2 or a 1-2-2 set. That leaves the baseline open because there's so much pressure on those backline guys to watch cutters going to the basket that it leaves the corner open, and Ruben Slock steps out and says, get me the basketball, and he knocks down the jumper.